Karen, I know that you have written a book about your experience through this whole ordeal.
Yes.
And what is that called?
It's Why Can't Sharon Kowalski Come Home? And that's for the 9.5 years. Why did it take that long for Sharon to be allowed to come home following an accident? It was published back in 1987, and it served its purpose. It helped break open the case. What we asked was, how can we get the story out? We had the press lesbian bitter over outcome a case instead of woman with a disability denied her right to be tested for competency, or woman with a disability denied her right to see her friends. And so I thought the only way we were ever going to get the true story out, whole story out, was to tell it ourselves. So we wrote the book, and it's done its purpose. And really, probably nothing else ever needs to be said beyond this book. That doesn't really need another ending. But it was used in different family law classes to show how the law that's supposed to protect people's rights failed in this case. Some medical ethics classes used it. Are people in medicine? Do we just treat a specific part of a person, like an OT or PT, or are you treating the whole person? And so it caused a lot of questions to be asked, and so, as I said, I think some wonderful things have happened with it. But at the same time, I still get emails from all over the country. People will pick up the book, or somebody will hear about the case, and then they'll say, what happened to Sharon? And they don't know she's even home. She's been home for 18 and a half years. I mean, a judge told me she couldn't be cared for outside of a nursing home, and yet she's been home for 18 and a half years. I can't keep answering those questions. Well, tell us what happened one-on-one. So we are going to start a second book.
Right.
And probably that book, I'd like to see titled, instead of Part 2, Why Can't Sharon Kowalski Come Home, or Sharon Kowalski Came Home, I'd like it to be Love is a Dangerous Promise. I think people make commitments or partial commitments to folks, and they really don't know what that means. I mean, when I told Sharon I'd be there for her forever, I meant that.
You certainly did.
God, I love Sharon as much today or more than I have ever loved Sharon. And I think love changes in different situations as things happen throughout our lives. But she is the neatest person. When people get to know Sharon, she just she changes people's lives. So we need to write the second book and to talk about what happened, of course, how we got from here to where we are today. And talk perhaps more about the different support systems that people need in place to enable people to live outside of an institution long term. Because you can't do it by yourself. Or there are just so many things that need to be done and so many hands you need at different times. But everybody shouldn't have to recreate the wheel. If we could just talk to each other and learn from each other's stories, that circular learning, I think the American Indian way of storytelling probably works much better than the linear learning that we grew up with.
Well, and you've certainly gone through so much.
Yeah.
It's nice that other people won't have to do this.
Yeah, we hope to finish our story, to let people know to where we are today.
Terrific. Yeah. Thank you again.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah.